I need your assistance with Intertherm furnace error codes.
I get why, since there are so few techs who could do it.
I'm not doing anything until I know what the flashing lights mean.
At least with working lights you know it is not failing to run due to a lack of power, like a blown fuse or tripped breaker. Intertherm furnaces are usually made by Nordyne.
A lot of furnaces and ACs are made by Nordyne, but they do not all use the same error codes.
The Intertherm M3RL gas furnace is only used in mobile homes and RVs. Actually, a lot of their furnaces are in those types of homes.
I know, since many could be adapted to run on liquid propane. That's why it was popular for those in rural areas or on the move.
Regardless of the model, Intertherm furnaces give two flashes if the pressure switch is open with inducer on. Three flashes indicates that the unit doesn't have continuity across the pressure switch.
That means fix the pressure switch or start checking why the pressure is wrong.
Two flashes can simply mean the pressure switch didn't close after 10 seconds, so a slow to close switch can do the same.
That does not change the need to fix something about it.
Four flashes means it has tried to ignite 5 times and failed.
Then it is locked out and I need to reset the furnace.
With a propane or gas-fueled Intertherm furnace, you need to have the thermostat open for at least 10 seconds to reset the control after a lockout. Otherwise it locks out for at least an hour.
What is a single blinking light?
For the gas furnaces, a blinking red LED blinking just once with a pause and so forth, usually means the limit switch is open.
What else can I check?
If the blower motor is not working and it is said to be on, check the transformer voltage.
I'm afraid that I'd get shocked to see what's wrong, so I'll just pay someone else to check the voltage instead.
Many Intertherm furnaces are really heat pumps, able to run hot or cold based on the setting. Check to make sure it is set to heat and not cool when it is not blowing hot air.
That's as silly as telling me to check the gas source still has fuel.
That's a lot more of a problem for people relying on a propane tank on the back of the RV or in the yard to keep their home warm, than it is relying on the municipal supply.
Valid point.
And if you literally run out of gas, it won't tell you until it flashes 5 times to say it has locked out because it did not have enough gas to ignite.